Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Becky, and today we are here to do a 12 by 12 layout that was for a challenge. Nope, it actually wasn't for a challenge, actually. I just happened to do this on the weekend of the Secret Not Secret Kit Club scrap party. This is actually my warm-up layout. You can see I am scrap lifting myself. I did put my original layout in the top left-hand corner of the screen. This is a super simple one. The original had a lot more layers and was a little bit more embellished. The one that I'm going to be doing today is not going to be quite as embellished. Now, I am still trying to work through some scraps. You can see right here, I do have that green plaid that I had cut up. That is a close to my heart paper. And then the navy blue, that is from a paper pad. I believe it was the Atlas Collection by Pink Paisley. So those are the scraps that I'm going to be using on here. For my background, I'll be using a piece of cardstock that is French vanilla from Close to My Heart. Now, when I try to put these down, the squares down there, not squares, I guess they're rectangles, down there at the bottom, I was trying to leave a little bit of border going all the way around the page. Well, in the original, first of all, I used several different, well, not several, I used three different papers. This one that I'm doing right here, I only used two different papers. In the original, I cut them different sizes, but in this one right here, I cut them all about the same size. Well, that second navy blue paper that I put down right there, I cut it a little bit crooked. You could tell because it would not flush up to that green. So I ended up overlaying it just a little bit over that plaid piece of paper. You can't really tell looking at it. I could tell at first when I was doing the layout and I thought it was going to end up causing me a big problem, but in the end it doesn't really. But you can see right there, I did have to trim a little bit off of that side because now they weren't the perfect width, right? Because I had to layered up over the plaid. See, it took away some of my width, so I did have to trim it down a little bit. So in the end, the scrapbook page isn't actually going to be 12 by 12. It's going to be like 11.9 by 12, but that's okay. I don't really care about that. I did decide to make one of my photos a little bit smaller than the other, and the reason that was is, I mean, it almost stretched across the whole page. So yeah, I went ahead and trimmed off some empty space on the second photo. I am going to mount it on this pretty green, it's a light green cardstock. It does, I forget the color of that, it does match that plaid paper that's down there at the bottom. I am going to also be cutting off another strip of this Atlas Collection, the navy blue, to go across right there to serve as the band. I did have another one up there at the top that I had put down as well. Now for the embellishments, I pulled out a embellishment pack. This is from Coco Vanilla. Is it called Boys Rule, Boys Home, Boys For? I don't know. It's a boy collection, and I didn't get any of the papers for this collection. I didn't snag it up in enough time, but I was able to find the embellishment pack at a later date. I am going to be using that Cool Kid for my title, so I have a little bit more light blue in there. It's okay, because I'm going to pull in a little bit more with that tag, and also on his shirt, you can see there's a little bit of blue. So I feel like that light blue is perfectly fine to have in there. I'm also going to be adding in gray. I put that scalloped bit up at the top, and then some of the stars I use are gray. And that picture frame, and also I pulled out that word awesome, which is also in gray. So yeah, this is kind of a navy blue, green, and gray layout. I think it actually looks really cute. I like those colors together. I think it looks really good. You can see right here, I did not line that up just perfectly, so I'm just going to move it up a little bit. I ripped the paper, but that's okay. It's going to be covered by this photo anyway. We're going to go ahead and start with our clustering bits. Up at the top, I am doing the Cool Kit. See right here? Oh, did you see that? I just showed you that tag. I'm tucking that in at the side of the photo bit. I used washi tape. Even though this wasn't for a challenge, I was able to count the pieces that were on her 15 items list as points, and washi tape was on there. And I don't know. I don't use washi tape the way a lot of people use washi tape. In fact, I buy it, but I don't hardly use it for anything other than to hold my dies down when I'm doing die cutting, or to hold down brads on the back of my page. That's pretty much the use of washi tape I do. But because you got points for using the washi tape, I did this time. You'll see a couple layouts that I did. I used washi tape to serve as the twine through my tags. So yeah, that's what I end up doing. On this one, this little piece over here, it gave me such a hard time. This wood veneer piece is from Close to My Heart. And also the pop dots I'm using are from Close to My Heart. Well, I always buy the 1 millimeter dots. And this wood veneer is actually more like 2 millimeters, maybe just a smidge less, but yeah, right about 2 millimeters. I couldn't get it balanced just right. I ended up having to pull that star off and put another pop dot on back of my pop dot, right? So I doubled it up so it could be the same height or higher than that wood veneer. That was a little bit of a pain. It took me a minute to kind of try and figure that out. I know that's ridiculous, right? I am going to go ahead and commit to where the cool kid is. I do layer up the kid over the cool part. I think that's kind of a neat little interesting thing to look at right there. I also am going to be popping up this star on some foam tape. I'm going to sit it right there. Now, because I did use that wood veneer down there at the bottom, I do want to put in a couple more pieces. I put these very small chevron type looking arrows pointing toward the cool and cool kid, and then a size that's slightly bigger I'm putting down here on this tag. So I do have the wood veneer in all the places. Now, in other layouts I did during the same weekend, I was using this same wood veneer and I was coloring them with acrylic ink. And I actually like that effect as well. On this particular layout, probably I could have done that and got away with it. It would have looked good as well, but I went ahead and kept it just the raw naked wood. Now right here I'm just putting two little hearts down because again you get extra points for using hearts. So I did pull out two puffy hearts and put one up at the top and one down at the bottom. Mixing hearts and stars, I don't do that very often, but if it gets me extra points, right? So that's what I did on this one. I pulled out my Karataki watercolors and I thought that I was splattering around copper, but it ended up being more of a bronze, or actually to me it looks like the Heidi Swap color Shine and Tea, but it's not. It's kind of a bronze color of watercolor. All right, guys, after I do that, I'm not doing anything else this layout. I want to thank you so much for joining me, and I will see you next time. Bye, guys.